Oh, parts printed. I printed two of them because I thought they are so cool. I needed to. My little son's going to be very happy. This one was printed in PLA, and it came out very, very good. Good according to the speed it was printed. That was printed very fast. Look at that surface finish. Very awesome. This is the Uzzy PLA filament. Came out great. This is the top cover as well. This one came out great as well. Very good stuff. And I printed another one in this is polycarbonate carbon fiber. Well, it's a CPE. It's a blend. So it's printable. It's easier to print. Say it that way. It came out great, though. It's not the best filament I've seen. It's a little hard to print, but it comes out good, and that stuff is really, really, really strong. Here's the cover. Came out pretty good as well. It doesn't do a very awesome finish like other carbon fiber material, but it's gonna be a good one. A quick note, that the first time I printed with that filament, I mean, the spool, come on, focus. I want to show you this one. This is right out of a brand new spool. Same STL, same G-code, same printing, same thing with this one. This one is straight out of the box, brand new. The filament was in a sealed bag, and it was very well sealed, except look at that crap, how it printed. I was just like, whoa, there's something wrong. And I just dried the filament overnight, started the print again, and boom, printing perfect. So just a quick note, dry your carbon fiber filaments, guys, because yeah, they are absorbing moisture. Even if they're brand new from the factory, they will absorb moisture. So we got everything printed. Those are ASA, those little clips, ASA, super bright orange. I don't know on the camera, they don't seem very bright, but they are bright, trust me. And we're ready to assemble. So this one's pretty good, pretty easy to do. We have a TPU gasket that you just put in the groove here. And I'm not sure if it's gonna be super watertight because of one thing. Remember, we print with a 3D printer, and there is a seam on that little gasket, on that TPU gasket. So I don't know if it's gonna be watertight. We're gonna test it to see, but this is how it assembled. And the guy that made this design is very, very awesome. I love it so much. It fits perfect. It just looks so good. And yeah, it's parametric. So when you open that up in CAD, you can play with the dimensions. There are settings you can adjust, so that's gonna allow you to lengthen or make it larger, make it thicker. You can basically customize every settings on that box and make it as big or as small or whatever as you want. And I think it's a awesome print. If you don't know what to print this weekend, go ahead, print that box. I'm gonna put a link in the description down below. Big thumbs up for the designer of this one, and it's really easy to assemble. You're gonna need the 3 30mm M3 screws. You're gonna need one here. Just be careful, there's one side that is bigger, so it goes from like that. Just screw it in. Same thing on the other side. And there you go. This thing is just purely awesome. You have a nice box, 3D printed, that you can clip, and listen to this guy. You just clip it on like that, and it's tight. I don't know how tight it is. We're gonna put that in water and see if that water will come in or go in, but even if it doesn't, I don't care. It's a very, very awesome print to do. So I'm gonna make them bigger and put my tools in there. You can print them with different colors, but I thought orange like that was very looking gorgeous. And let's see. Yeah, works good. Oh, that is so satisfying. Listen to this. It clips very good. Awesome design. That designer is a genius. Wow. All right, let's assemble this one, and we're gonna put that in water and see. No bubble yet. Oh, let me see with this one. Let's see inside. Oh well, it didn't quite work well on this one. Let's see the other one. All wet. So we got a little issue, and I think it comes because of that seam here. So maybe if I print this guy, the little TPU gasket, a little thicker, that might actually work, because it was close, but I can feel that it's probably not thick enough to make a perfect seal. Might be my printing, I don't know. I'll try to make it thicker and see if that helps, but that's gonna be for a different day. For now, that was a cool experiment though. So anyway, thank you very much for watching this one. I had fun doing it, and those bucks, even though are not yet airtight or watertight, my son loved them, and he's gonna put his things inside, and that's gonna be good for him. And I'm gonna print others for my girlfriend because she loved them, and I'm gonna make them bigger. So if you like that design, I'm gonna put a link in the description down below. Feel free to download it. And a big shout out, a big thank you to that designer there who made that box. It's a very, very nice design. So thank you for watching. I hope you appreciated that video. It was a pleasure for me. I had fun. So on this, folks, thanks again, and see you on the next one. Take care. Have a good one. Bye.